It's the middle of the summer. The 4th of July has come and gone, and you've gotten a cold from one of the many cousins that came to visit you.
Thanks a lot, Todd.
Today we're going to make one of the best side dishes to any soup or southern United States meal, and that is sour cream cornbread. Come on, let's do this. To make this edible bar of gold, you're going to need the following. Flour, cornmeal, baking powder, salt, baking soda, butter, sugar, large eggs, and I would suggest large chicken eggs. If you grab your ostrich eggs, you've gone too far. Milk from a cow is suggested. Sour cream, and natural liquid sugar, otherwise known as thick sugar. Honey is the preferred flavor. But today we're out of honey, so I'm going to be increasing the amount of corn flavor and throwing in some no-fructose corn syrup. First things first, you need to mix your dry ingredients together in a big glass bowl. Start out with 1 cup of flour, then add in a 3/4 cup of powdered gold, corn. If you don't have a 1/4 cup, do what I do and use a 1/2 cup, and then just fill it halfway for the extra 4th%. Math, people! It'll save your life! Add in 7 1/4 teaspoons of baking powder. Do not confuse this with the salt like baking soda. If you use soda instead of powder, not only do you run the risk of the cornbread tasting way too salty, you're entering uncharted territories. If you've already confused the two, restart the video. If you're challenged in the whole powdered salt trend and you only have rock salt, then get out your mortar and pestle and pour in exactly this much salt. Crush it just like you would have if you lived in the days of yore. If this is getting complicated and you feel bogged down by all these instructions, just remember, cooking isn't an exact science. Think of yourself as an alchemist. They were trying to find the philosopher's stone so they could turn lead into gold and create the elixir of life. Or maybe they were just bored, who knows. But instead of combining elements and explosive materials, you're combining flavors. Just like they did, it can be totally random and without any instructions. Follow the basics, and you can go crazy with flavors. You're a pioneer in the world of cooking. You could create a combination of flavors so exotic that people wonder how they lived without it before its creation. Of course, it could just turn into a huge bowl of cat food, but cats need to eat too. 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda goes in next. If you've confused the two again, then you really need to restart the video. Wait, I just put in sugar crud. Well, it'll just taste a bit sweeter, who cares? Use a whisk and exterminate all chances of them staying separated. Set it aside. Now,
for the liquid.
First, you'll need butter. We need only 5 tablespoons, so we'll have to do some corrections to the stick. Use your vorpal blade and behead your opponent. Toss the remaining 3 tablespoons aside. You'll need them later. Melt the 5 tablespoons of butter using your preferred method of melting. You could go caveman style and breathe on it if you want. You could use the stove. You could even bake it in the oven. Me, I use the microwave. Take this time to make sure that it was raw eggs that you grabbed and not hard-boiled eggs. If they spin like a ballerina, then you've gotten a hard one and you need to grab a different one. If they wobble into each other, oh, shnikes! Check for cracks. If there are any, make an omelet. Take the butter out of the microwave and add 3 tablespoons of sugar. This is important. We want the butter sweet and the sugar dissolved before we add the eggs and milk. Otherwise, we just end up with clumps of sugar and lumps of butter inside of our milk. Whisk them together. Add in the eggs. Cracking them with one hand is absolutely necessary. Whisk them together until you've accidentally created butter pudding. If you're a mad lad, and I certainly hope you are, you can do this next step without a second measuring cup. We need to add 1/2 cup of milk. So, we do basic math here. Measure how much liquid has filled up the bowl, and mentally calculate how high the mixed liquid should be when the milk is added. Or, you can calculate exactly, like I can do, how much liquid is currently inside the measuring cup, and then add 1/2 cup to that. Add in the 1/2 cup of milk, and create eggnog. Don't drink this, this is not very good eggnog, and it's nowhere near Christmas time. Now the most important part. To make this heavenly bar of edible gold, you are going to scoop a half a cup of sour cream into the mix. Ah, shoot, I forgot to preheat the oven. Preheat the oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit, or around 220 degrees Celsius for all of you non-Americans out there, because I know non-Americans watch this channel. Ha! Now add in the thick sugar. Most people would say, well, you don't need that much sugar, I mean, come on, it's just gonna be cornbread, it's supposed to be savory. You're supposed to be able to just put this into soup, but I say no! I say eyeball it, insert it until it tastes good. Don't get stingy with the syrup and honey, who cares if this is sweet, be generous with it. Sticky it all up and don't stop until the very thing reeks of sugar and spice and everything nice. And one bite of this cornbread would give you enough fat to survive a Siberian winter on nothing but whisk it all together until the consistency reminds you of whatever this reminds you of. Taste for quality! Tastes like candy corn fed Iowa milk. Bless the butter rains down in the cornmeal Africa. Whisk it all together. If it turns out that your mad lad skills are nowhere near as good as you would have thought, just add in a little bit more flour until the blended product is slightly less thick than frosting. If it's thicker than frosting, then add a little bit more milk. But in the end, if you just keep adding thick and thin and thick and thin into the thing, and you end up with sweet butter flavored milk and flour, then you've gone too far. Restart the video. Set it aside and get out your bread pan. You can make muffins if you want, in which case it'll only take 14 to 16 minutes to bake. But not in this house! Ha! Cornbread muffins are for crumbling into soup, not dipping. We need cornbread. Take the butter you've tossed aside, unwrap it, and then squeeze it like it was the heart of your enemies. Grease the pan with your greasy hand. Make sure all butter that tries to escape is immediately dealt with. Get out your spatula and let the rains of cornbread dough spill into the glass pan. Make it flat and pretty, but not too pretty. You're going to eat this, not Instagram it. Well, of course, if you are Instagramming this, then surely you have more capabilities of making things pretty than I do. I mean, come on. Pop it into the oven. And set the timer for 10 minutes. Once the 10 minutes are up, turn it down to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. And set the timer for 30 minutes. Take this time to clean up your mess or mock your friends online since they do not share your culinary genius. After 30 minutes, check on the bread. You need to stab it with a knife. If you're squeamish, then have someone else stab it. If the knife comes out clean, then the bread is ready. If the knife has bread guts on it, though, then continue cooking the bread for 10-minute increments until the inside is ready. Keep stabbing until that knife comes out clean. Oh, now we're in business. Take it out, let it cool for about 10 minutes, then cut it free from the pan. Let it roll onto the wire mesh platform, and then slice off the biggest piece you can. This bread is all for you. Well, thank you for watching, my friends. I will see you next time, and keep on cooking. Adios.